Hello, I'm Dr. Carlo Oger for edexitvideo.com. Today I want to take you inside the mind of an emergency medicine physician as we work through the process of differentiating the different causes of chest pain. There's three diagnoses we're going to worry about right away whenever somebody tells us they have chest pain. This is because these three diagnoses are minutes to hours emergencies where we really have to pinpoint what's wrong or else the person could deteriorate and die. These are acute heart attack, or acute MI for short, a pneumothorax, which is the same as saying a collapsed lung, and a thoracic aortic dissection. There's a couple of things the doctor is going to ask you or should ask you if you have chest pain. Let's start with the characters of the pain. First, the location of the pain. You know, is it in the middle of the chest? Is it on the left side? Is it more in the back? You know, that's going to help us differentiate the different structures around the chest that are present so we can help us decide which way are we going with this. Not only the location of the pain, but how it radiates. Does it go into your shoulder? Does it go into your arm? Does it radiate up into the neck and into your jaw? Those are very important findings that will help us, in our mind, differentiate between the different type of disorders. Then we have the severity of the pain. Is this a mild pain? Is this a moderate pain or severe? We'll often ask you a pain scale. It's not that we're playing games and we want you to say a number to tell us how we're going to treat you. But you know, the severity of the pain does kind of tell us how acute or how bad this could be. Then we have the character of the pain. Is it pressure? Is it tightness? Is it squeezing? And when the patient grabs their chest like this and puts their fist to their chest, we call that a Levine sign. And that just tells us more likely to be cardiac. Is it an aching, nagging kind of pain? Worries us more about cardiac disease and cardiac nature. Is it a burning pain that's really not here but in the epigastrium, lower chest? Maybe something more like reflux or gastric problems are far more likely. Is it a very sharp pain over here in the shoulder that gets worse when you breathe? That points to more maybe a collapsed lung or a pulmonary embolism or something like that. Then we have the onset of the pain. Is it something that started a week ago and slowly grew? Is it something that's been there for a week at the same level, hasn't changed? Less likely to be something emergent or dangerous, something that changes in nature, that's getting worse, or that started suddenly and it's really bad, will point us to a more severe nature of your pain. Then we got the what makes it better, what makes it worse. This is very important. For example, a pressure pain that gets worse every time you go a flight of stairs is more dangerous than a pain that's steady and you just walk and it doesn't change, it's always the same, or is a pain that changes when I do this, when I bend a certain way, when I lay on my side, more likely to be chest wall pain, a costochondritis, and not a heart attack, not angina or something severe like that. And then associated signs and symptoms. Are you nauseous? Are you short of breath? Did you break out in a sweat and soaked your shirt when it happened? Were you mowing the lawn when it happened? Do you have any swollen legs? Things that could pinpoint to a blood clot that travel into your lung. You know, is there a rash associated with it? Have you been wheezing and coughing? More likely to be bronchitis or something like that. Definitely, all these things are very important. Not only that the doctor knows this, but maybe he forgets to ask you about these things. You need to let us know. Also, family history. Family history is very important. Is there brothers, sisters, mom or dad with coronary artery disease? Is there history of early heart disease, not just heart disease? Is there family history of blood clots, DVTs or PEs, because they're more likely you might have a blood clotting disorder that could put you at risk for the same thing? Is there a history of thoracic aortic dissection or aneurysms in your chest or abdomen, because those put you at more risk for the same disease? Now this video is just to pinpoint and educate you on what goes through the mind of a doctor, what things we worry about and ask for the different disorders or medical illness that cause chest pain. But you need to watch the individual videos also present on my website, EDExit Video, if you want to know more about each specific diagnosis. For example, pulmonary embolism, a clot to the lung, a collapsed lung or pneumothorax, an acute heart attack or angina, you got pneumonia, pleurisy, you got atelectasis, you got bronchitis and reflux disease, all those things we mentioned at other points of the video, you can get to my website, ED Exit Video, go through the list, find your specific diagnosis you're worried about, or maybe that I mentioned that kind of matches your symptoms, and then educate you better. I hope this was helpful, so make sure you like us. Thank you.